Prime Minister declares extension of the nationwide lockdown till 3rd of May, asks authorities to look after measures to make life easy for the poor. Assam reports fresh COVID-19 positive case from Gwalpara district, raises the state tally to 31. Country's battle against outbreak of novel coronavirus reaches a new level. State machineries gear up to face any situation. Global COVID-19 positive cases rises to 19,34,557. The death toll rises to 1,20,408. Meghalaya records its first case. And the nation remembers Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar, known as the chief architect of the Indian Constitution, on his 129th birth anniversary. Good evening, viewers, and welcome to the Northeast News Bulletin. This is Ajanta Chaudhary, now with the details. The government has decided to extend lockdown till 3rd of May. Addressing the nation today, Prime Minister Narendra Modi said stakeholders, including states and people, have favoured extension of lockdown. Modi said integrated and holistic approach has helped India to handle the situation properly. He further said tight vigil will be kept on all hotspots and containment zones, and strict implementation of the lockdown will be ensured in coming days so that the virus does not spread to new areas.
3 मई तक और बढ़ाना पड़ेगा यानी 3 मई तक हम सभी को हर देशवासी को लॉकडाउन में ही रहना होगा इस दौरान हमें अनुशासन का उसी तरह पालन करना है जैसे हम करते आ रहे हैं मेरी सभी देशवासियों से ये प्रार्थना है कि अब कोरोना को हमें किसी भी कीमत पर नए क्षेत्रों में फैलने नहीं देना है स्थानीय स्तर पर अब एक भी मरीज बढ़ता है तो ये हमारे लिए चिंता का विषय होना चाहिए कहीं पर भी कोरोना से एक भी मरीज की दुखद मृत्यु होती है तो हमारी चिंता और बढ़नी चाहिए और इसलिए हमें हॉटस्पॉट्स को इंगित करके पहले से भी ज्यादा बहुत ज्यादा सतर्कता बरतनी ही होगी
Prime Minister lauded the patience and discipline of citizens in making lockdown successful. Modi said earlier preparedness helped the country in effective containment of infection. He sought people's support in 7 things to make the entire effort a success, which includes taking care of elderly, maintaining social distancing and helping the poor. He urged people to respect corona warriors, the doctors, nurses, sweepers and police personnel.
ऐसे व्यक्ति जिन्हें पुरानी बीमारी हो उनकी हमें एक्स्ट्रा केयर करनी है उन्हें कोरोना से बहुत बचाकर रखना है दूसरी बात लॉकडाउन और सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग की लक्ष्मण रेखा का पूरी तरह पालन करें
Assam reports a fresh COVID-19 positive case. With this, the state tally rises to 31. The fresh coronavirus case has been reported from Gwalpara district. Assam Health and Family Welfare Minister Himanta Biswa Sarma said that the new case is the secondary contact of the Nizamuddin Markaz case. Out of the 31 COVID-19 positive cases, 9 cases alone were reported from Gulaghat district. A patient from Hailakandi district succumbed to the infection on April 10 last. Lav Agarwal, Joint Secretary of Ministry of Health and Family Welfare today said that the country's battle against outbreak of novel coronavirus has reached at a new level and the state machineries have been geared up to face any situation likely to arise from the pandemic. Agarwal informed that till today 2,31,902 samples have been tested in country's 166 government labs and 70 private labs. The government has decided to provide 5 kgs of food items to 80 crore people, and for this 22 lakh tons of food materials have been stocked in country's civil supply godown. Agarwal said that there is no compromise on maintaining social distancing norms as it is very vital to check spread of the COVID-19 pandemic. Maharashtra still tops the list of number of coronavirus infected cases in the country. Global COVID-19 positive cases have risen to 19,34,557. The death toll has risen to 1,20,408. United States continues to top the chart of COVID-19 positive cases. New York City, the epicenter of the COVID-19 pandemic in the United States, now alone has over 1 lakh novel coronavirus cases. According to the official data, this is more than the confirmed cases in China and the United Kingdom. Chief Minister Sarbanand Sonowal today, while addressing media persons at his residence in Dibrugarh, appreciated people of Assam for observing the 21-day national lockdown call given by Prime Minister Narendra Modi. He urged the people to follow the lockdown extension call given by Prime Minister Modi till 3rd May in order to contain the coronavirus pandemic in the country, and emphasized on strictly adhering to social distancing norms so that COVID-19 spread can be totally controlled during this lockdown extension period. Appreciating the roles played by the Health Department, Food and Civil Supplies Department, Police, Safai Karmi, ANM, Asha Karmi, MPWs, etc., in containing coronavirus outbreak in Assam, Sonowal thanked PM Modi's swift and decisive action, which has resulted in the country's better performance in this fight against the deadly virus.
Laboratory technician Hakol.
Meghalaya on Monday registered the first COVID-19 positive case. The COVID-19 positive patient is a 69-year-old doctor of Bethany Hospital in Shillong. Confirming the news, Meghalaya Health Minister Al Hek on Monday said the doctor tested positive for the deadly COVID-19 virus. Hek said Bethany Hospital has been sealed indefinitely. Family members of the patient would be put under home quarantine, Hek said. All the patients who had visited Bethany Hospital on or after March 22 were requested to register themselves by calling 108. The Shillong doctor is the first COVID-19 positive case of Meghalaya. In a video clip shared on his Twitter handle, Chief Minister Conrad Sangma also requested the citizens of the state not to come out of their homes in the next 48 hours. He also requested all the citizens to call at 108 if they had visited Bethany Hospital in the last 20 days. Nation remembers Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar on his 129th birth anniversary today. Dr. Ambedkar is known as the chief architect of the Indian Constitution and has been bestowed with the country's high civilian honour, Bharat Ratna, in 1990 posthumously. Baba Saheb Bhimrao Ambedkar was born on 14th April 1891 at Mhow, now known as Dr. Ambedkar Nagar in Madhya Pradesh. Dr. Ambedkar was a known jurist, economist, politician and social reformer who worked hard throughout his life to end social discrimination against weaker sections of the society. He became the first law and justice minister after the independence and played an important role in drafting the Indian Constitution and made provisions for abolition of all forms of discrimination. He inspired the Dalit Buddhist movement in India and embraced Buddhism on 14th October 1956. Dr. Ambedkar's legacy as a social political reformer is respected across the world. His thoughts have played an important role in transforming the views of India's socio-economic problems. Today is Manu Bihu, the second day of Rongali Bihu celebration in Assam. The celebration has been symbolic only. Manu Bihu involves the tradition of seeking blessings from the elders in a family and presenting the ceremonial patch of Bihuan as a gift to be worn as symbol of cultural pride. The fear of coronavirus and the lockdown to prevent its spread kept most of the people of the state indoors on Tuesday, the second day of the Rongali Bihu celebration. Since last week, authorities have been issuing diligent reminders about how to celebrate Bihu during COVID-19 with proper social distancing norms. As early as March 20, before the nationwide lockdown was announced, 26 Bihu committees across the state decided not to hold cultural stage programs, an important part of the Bihu festivities, especially in the urban areas. The UN General Assembly meetings scheduled for the next few months have been postponed due to the COVID-19 pandemic. A senior official of the UN said the member states are holding discussions on how to proceed with the high-level annual UN General Assembly session in September. Earlier this month, President of the 74th session of UN General Assembly, Tijani Muhammad Bande, had decided to postpone the General Assembly meetings scheduled for April and May in light of the guidance severely limiting in-person meetings as a result of the rapidly evolving COVID-19 pandemic. All in-person meetings of General Assembly mandated processes scheduled to be held between April 17 and the end of May also stand cancelled. As Assam celebrates Rongali Bihu with strict guidelines due to coronavirus and COVID-19, today, despite being a holiday, a unique and unprecedented scene was witnessed at the Dikom Tea Estate in Upper Assam's Dibrugarh district. Workers at the garden today decided to work, and that too without their wages for the day, as a gesture towards their management and employers who had provided them with wages, ration, medical assistance, etc. during the 21-day lockdown, despite the garden accumulating huge losses. There are around 1,200 permanent workers and almost equal number of temporary workers. Deputy Commissioner Kifir Sarita Yadav has informed that in view of the active case detected in Dimapur, some of the areas at Dimapur like Marwaripati, Gorapati and including the Zion Hospital has been sealed. In this regard, all such persons who have arrived in the Kifir district on or after 24th March 2020 from Dimapur and have visited the sealed areas or market during their stay at Dimapur have been requested to inform the Kefir District Task Force about such visit. And with that, we end this evening's bulletin. Thank you for tuning in. Namaskar.